Okay, so Perry, what have you got here? What rigs have you been using recently?
It's a combi rig. I can fish it two ways, you know, like if there's a change, if as I come and it's set up on the rod, I can fish it in two ways. It can be okay. Changed into a pop-up straight away, okay. Or a fish as a bottom bait.
And how do you do that? How do you change it from one to the other?
Well, this silicone that I've got on the shank of the hook there.
Yep, okay.
I push that round when I'm fishing on the bottom. Sometimes you extend the stop in here, depending on the thing. I like a little bit of gap
okay.
in the thingy, and it will always catch
it. So always basically. A good hook hold on there.
But if you tried to fish a pop-up on that like that, yep. It would naturally want to sit like that.
Right, okay.
So it's sitting wrong, basically, yeah?
Okay.
So if you move the silicone back along the shank and yep. the hook, almost meeting where we've got the curve.
Absolutely, shank, right? Okay, yeah.
That will then sit. Obviously, I'd have to put a bit of shot on, but that will then just sit either hovering or depending on how buoyant, obviously, if I've got a full pop-up on there or
yeah.
if I'm going to, you know, fish it critically balanced. So you can change it without having to change rigs.
Okay.
So that was the Fantastic. Idea behind it in the first place.
So fairly universal there.
What I liked about it, I mean, obviously, I know that with this coated braids and obviously we do the hyperlink as well, which is the reverse of a coated braid,
it's absolutely
with the fluorocarbon inside. But what I like about it is the pure fluorocarbon power link
okay.
that I use here. There's no better camouflage than you can't see it at all, you know. And I always fish it with the putty on there.
Okay, which covers the knot up.
Covers the knot, not for the reasons for that. I think it helps in the hooking, really.
Okay.
I really do. I just that little bit of weight, you know. You've got the flexibility there, obviously, of the power link.
Yep.
And
it just drops the bottom of the hook down, so as the hook goes in, it's already sat.
Exactly, it's helped pulling it down.
Yeah. And what's the material you're using at the end there for your more supple?
This is the power silk.
That's the power silk.
Power silk,
okay.
Yeah, down to the power link.
Excellent. And, okay. And so, how are you joining these two together? Is it sort of the standard knot for tying two together?
Whether it's one that everyone uses standard, you know, like you always think you've got a little twist on it yourself.
Absolutely.
It's like a double balloon. I'll show you on the some okay. other bits I've got cut off there if we can.
Absolutely.
Just bear with me.
Okay.
Obviously, without the hook and that attached, it's I call them like a balloon, if you like.
Right. Okay.
So it's just a little overhand knot, and then a twist again to bring another loop in front of it, another balloon.
Okay.
Then I bring this one through the two of them.
Gotcha.
Yeah. So then when I pull that one, that'll adjust, and when I pull that one, that'll adjust. Yeah.
Fantastic.
Right. Then this would be obviously attached to the hook on it. Yeah.
Okay.
Now you pull that through, and the tighter you can take that up to the eye of the hook, yeah, the shorter you'll make that braided section.
Right, gotcha.
Okay. So then, we pulled that through. Now what we're going to do with this is we're going to do like a five-turn grinner knot, really.
Okay.
So straight through the loop, trapping the power link, in between.
Always going round the main body of your rig.
That's right. Yeah, exactly. So that goes round. Just for the thingy of this, I'll just go around three times just to show you what I mean. But I normally do four or five turns on it. And then what I'll do is I'll just wet that down. Not pulling it really tight at the moment, just going to let that rest. And then pulling the tag end of the balloons and the main boom section,
okay,
wetting
the
those.
Fluorocarbon there, yeah.
You see them both shrinking down. Yeah. And then when you pull those both up tight, they lock in together.
Fantastic.
And then you're just cutting off the tag ends. And
that's always been a fairly solid knot for you.
I've never had any problems with it, and that's what I would use even with a leader. I've got no problem using that on a leader knot or anything. So, but that is the rig mechanics of it.
Fantastic, okay. Are there any particular situations you would opt for using this over, say, other rigs out there? Or?
I've got to be honest, the only rig above this what I would ever change to is a chod.
Yeah.
And that's if I'm fishing in, obviously, in a weedier situation, really. So this one does everything for me, you know.
Fantastic.
Bottom bait, set up, and
pop-ups.
You say,
and you're happy fishing that on silt or gravel areas?
Yep, no problem at all, because literally power link is fluorocarbon. So you can't see it on
invisible.
Whatever you're fishing over. So, you know, and that little small section of braid is nothing, you know.
No, absolutely.
So, and that, you know, that would blend in with silt. It will take on probably the silt colour in the water, you know. And that's the rig I'm using.
Might have to give it a go myself.
Give it a go, sir.
Excellent.